Okay, good morning once again. So welcome you to the lecture series on Neumann circuits. So today we are going to start the next lecture from module number 4. Altogether this is will be the lecture number 38 or 8th lecture from module number 4. Now yesterday we sort of did some kind of analysis on summing amplifier, and then I try to give some inputs regarding offset voltages, or basically the offset compensation network. I thought I should make it even much clearer before I proceed further. So this is a small figures I have drawn to make you understand how the offsets, or what exactly we mean by offset voltage or offset current, or input offset voltage or output offset voltage, which we basically hear now and then. So the first half of this lecture will be dedicated towards an understanding what exactly we mean by the offset. And then in the second half, we'll try to solve some numericals. And possibly in the next lecture, we'll take up the instrumentation amplifier, that concept. Okay, so from the figure one, I have drawn a circuit wherein both the inputs I have grounded. So as you can see over here, both the inverting terminal as well as the non-inverting terminal, I have grounded, and I have given one voltage VIO at the inverting terminal. I'll come to this, what exactly this means. Now, before that, let me give you a definition of what exactly input offset voltage mean. So input offset voltage is the differential input voltage that exists between two input terminals of an op amp without any external inputs being applied. So that means whenever we fabricate an op amp, and if we check the output by making the inputs grounded, we will still get the output. But what exactly we should get? We should get the output as zero. But nang zero barangilla. That zero yak barangilla pa antandra, there will be some sort of voltage difference that will be present between these inverting and non-inverting terminals. So basically, when we try to understand what is happening at the input side and output side, we could see that there will be some sort of noise that will be present at the input side, or there will be some sort of disturbances, or because of the manufacturing issues itself, there will be some voltage difference that will be present at the input side. Our voltage in the other than offset voltage, and because of this offset voltage, then output voltage zero per angle. Output voltage I'm going to get as some value. So, in other words, it is the amount of input voltage that should be applied between two input terminals in order to force the output voltage to zero. So then output voltage zero barangilla, zero bit eno and value bantapa. So nan output voltage nangi sal zero madbekandre, yes to input voltage nan apply madbeku. So that is my input offset voltage. So basically, when I start my operation, before I start my operation, like when I give the inputs to ground, there will be some difference voltage that will be present. So that is my input offset voltage. And because of this difference voltage that is present at the input side, there will be some output voltage. So my job is to ensure that this input voltage difference, whatever I am seeing here, which I am calling it as an input offset voltage, adanna nanu zero madabeku athava adanna nanu nullify madabeku, adanna eliminate madabeku. I eliminate madlikna yes to voltage apply martenna, that is known as input offset voltage, which I am going to apply. So basically here I am denoting the input offset voltage by VIO and output offset voltage as VOO. So basically output offset voltage na yavag bartappa andre input offset voltage iddagane output offset voltage bartada. Offset andre enu? Some extra voltage, right? So input olage enadru some difference in the voltages nanage iddaga, definitely nan output nan zero barangilla, output will have some sort of value. So nanage I can say that the output offset voltage is caused by mismatching between two input terminals. I can say this. So idu yak agutappa antandra, this is as I was telling, it is because of some sort of noise. Yakandre op amp yavattu standalone device anta use madangilla, op amp will be used in collaboration with other circuits. ಯಾವತ್ತು ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಸರ್ಕಿಟ್ ಅಥವಾ ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಡಿವೈಸ್ ನಾನು ಅದೊಂದೇ ಅಂತ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಂಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದ್ರ ಹಿಂದ್ಗಡೆ ಅದ್ರ ಮುಂದ್ಗಡೆ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜಸ್. ಸೊ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದೋಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜಸ್ ಆರ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲ್ ನಾಯ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಫ್ಯಾಬ್ರಿಕೇಶನ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸಮ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಬೈ ವರ್ಚು ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾನುಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಚರಿಂಗ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ. ಮೊದಲೇ ಇದ್ದೇ ಬಿಡ್ತದೆ ಆ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ನ ನಲಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಆ ನಲಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಕ್ ನಾ ಎಷ್ಟು ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿಲ್ಲ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೈ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್. ಸಿ ಯೂಶ್ವಲಿ ವಿ ಸೇ ದಟ್ ಇವನ್ ದೋ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಕಂಪೋನೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಸೇಮ್ ಚಿಪ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೂ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಆಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ವಿತ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್. ಇವನ್ ವಿ ಸೇ ದಟ್ ನೋ ಟೂ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್, ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ 0.00001% ಆಫ್ ವೇರಿಯೇಷನ್. ಆ 0.0001% ಆಫ್ ವೇರಿಯೇಷನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ ಹ್ಯೂಜ್ ಇಂಪ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಐ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಐ ಅದನ್ನ ಹಂಗೆ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಪರ್ಕ್ಯುಲೇಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಹೈಯರ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜಸ್. ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ, ಯಾವತ್ತು ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಐ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಪರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೈ ಆಪ್ ಆಂಪ್ ಐ ಸಿ ಟು ದಟ್ ದ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಲ್ಲಿಫೈಡ್. ನಾವು ಈಗ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಏನಾದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಡಿಸಿ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್. ನಾವು ಇಟ್ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಆರ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್. ಯಾಕೆ ನನಗ ಇಟ್ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಆರ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಅಂತೇನಪ್ಪ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವಿ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಪ್ರೆಡಿಕ್ಟ್ ದಿ ಪೊಲಾರಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಸಿನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಆನ್ ಮಿಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಚಿಂಗ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್ಸ್. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ನನಗೆ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಇಲ್ಲೂ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಐ ಮೀನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್ ನಾಗರ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ನಾನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್ ನಾಗರ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ನಂಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಿಲ್ಲ. ನನಗೆ ಯಾವಾಗ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗತ್ತಪ್ಪ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಐತಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಯಾವಾಗ ನನಗೆ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಒಳಗೆ ವೆನ್ ಐ ಸಿ ಸಮ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ, ಅವಾಗ ನನಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗತ್ತೆ ಓಕೆ ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಮ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಸೈಡ್. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮಟ್ಟ ನನಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಯಾವತ್ತು ನಾನು ವೆನ್ ಐ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಬೋತ್ ದ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬೋತ್ ದ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನಾನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್ಸ್ ಟು ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್, ವೆನ್ ಐ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟು ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಬಟ್ ಐ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಸಮ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಓವರ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ದೆನ್ ಐ ಸೇ ದಟ್ ಓಕೆ ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಮ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಸೈಡ್. ಈಗ ನಾವು ವೆದರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಆರ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸೈಡ್ ಯಾವ ಜಾಗದಾಗ ನನಗೆ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಐತಿ ಅಂತ. ಲೈಕ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಇಫ್ ದ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಾದಂಗಾಯ್ತು, ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್, ಸೊ ವಿಚ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೈಯರ್, ಸೊ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಮೈ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಅಥವಾ ಸಮ್ ನಾಯ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಓವರ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿ ನಾನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್. ಇಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ದೆನ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ದಟ್ ಮೈ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಈಸ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್. ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಇವರು ವೆನೆವರ್ ದೇ ಮ್ಯಾನುಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಚರ್ ದಿ ಒಪ್ ಆಂಪ್ ದೇ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ಸಮ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಶೀಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಡೇಟಾ ಶೀಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಬಿಂಗ್ ಲಿಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆನ್ ಇಟ್. ಸೊ ಯೂಶ್ವಲಿ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರಪ್ಪ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಸೀ ಸಮ್ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ. ಲೈಕ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ದಿ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಇಸ್ 6 mV, ಅವ್ರ ದಿ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಇಸ್ 10 mV. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು, ಇದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರಕ್ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಅವ್ರ ಇದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಇರಾಕಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಯಾವಾಗ ಆಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕದ, ಇವನ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಯು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಪರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡಿವೈಸ್, ಇನ್ನು ನೀವು ಡಿವೈಸ್ ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ ಯಾವುದು ಕಾನ್ಫಿಗರೇಷನ್ ನಾಗ, ಇನ್ನು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೇ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿಲ್ಲ ನೀವು ಆಪರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ, ಅವಾಗ್ಲೇನೆ ದೀಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸಸೈಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್. ಸೊ ದೇ ಇನ್ ದ ಡೇಟಾ ಶೀಟ್ ದೇ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫೈ ದೀಸ್ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್, ದೇ ಸೇ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಇಷ್ಟ ಇರ್ತೈತಿ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದೇ ಸೇ. ನಾವು ಇಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಕೇಸ್ ದೆನ್ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಸಮ್, ಲೈಕ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಇಫ್ ಐ ಸೇ ನೌ ಐ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಸಮ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಬಂತು ಅಂಡ್ ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಸೇ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನೌ ಐ ನೋ ದಟ್ ಈ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಯಾಕೆ ಬರ್ಲಿಕ್ಕಪ್ಪ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಮ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿನ್ಸ್ ದ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಐ ಸೇ ದಟ್ ದ ಸಮ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಓವರ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ನಾನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಇಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್. ಅಥವಾ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಬಂತಪ್ಪ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಮ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್. ಸೊ ನಾವ್ ಐ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಸಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕ್ ಆಂಪ್ಲಿಟ್ಯೂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಪೊಲಾರಿಟಿ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಟು ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಟು 0. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ನನಗೆ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ 0 ಇಫ್ ಐ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಬೋತ್ ದ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್ಸ್ ಟು ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್, ಬಟ್ ಅದು ಹಂಗಾಗಿಲ್ಲ. ನಾವು ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಸಮ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ, ಅದನ್ನ ನಾನು 0 ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ನ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಆಫ್ ವಾಟ್ ಪೊಲಾರಿಟಿ, ಆಫ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆಂಪ್ಲಿಟ್ಯೂಡ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರೆಫರ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್. here I have applied some voltage. Like for example, if I am getting, for example, plus 6 millivolt, so that is because there is a voltage difference that is of 6 millivolt present over here. So nanaga adar the opposite polarity na illi apply maabitnappa antandra minus 6 millivolt. So then my difference will be nullified, or my the voltage will be nullified. Athwa na ill 6 millivolt illi apply maadidra, so the difference between these two will be nullified and now I am getting the output as zero. So na extra voltage in apply maadthini input side ge, so that is your input offset voltage. Now I try to nullify the output offset voltage by applying some input offset voltage. Now let's get into figure number 2. Now this is what is the figure number 2, which is basically how your output should look like. When you connect the inputs to ground, your output should be zero. If zero illappa antandra eno sali gadbad aithe andanga ee gadbad en madbeku nanu illi eno gadla aithe ee gadla avoid madlikke en madbeku illi just voltage extra bandaithe adra opposite polarity voltage na in apply madbeku, so that my output will be nullified. And all these exercises happening before you start applying your actual inputs, or before you start using the op amp in its actual configuration. Now to reduce the output voltage to zero, now ee nanagantu gothaytu I should reduce the output voltage to zero, that is offset output voltage to zero. To reduce this, we need to have a circuit at the input terminals that will give us flexibility of obtaining VIO of proper amplitude and polarity. Like idanna nanga output olaga nanga zero barbekanta fix aidige, ಇದನ್ನಂಗೆ ಜೀರೋ ಬರಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಒಳಗೆ ನಾವು ಒಂದು ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ನಾನು ಸುಮ್ ಸುಮ್ನೆ ಒಂದು ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಐ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಓವರ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಐ ಶುಡ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ದಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಸಮ್ ಸರ್ಕಿಟ್ರಿ. ದಟ್ ಸರ್ಕಿಟ್ರಿ ಈಸ್ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಕಂಪೆನ್ಸೇಟಿಂಗ್ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್. ಸೊ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ವಿ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಎನಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಟು ದಿ ಅಪ್ ಆಂಪ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಅನ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಕಂಪೆನ್ಸೇಟಿಂಗ್ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್, ವಿ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದಿ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಟು ಜೀರೋ. So with the help of the compensating network, what we do is we try to reduce the output voltage to zero. So if this happens, then I can say that op amp is balanced. We say that op amp is balanced. So this is what we do ensure the output is zero when we apply no voltages or no signals to the input side. Eager when we say I should apply the input voltage through some compensating network, then how does the compensating network looks, or will we have a standard compensating network, or will we have an inbuilt compensating network? The answer is yes. As you can see in figure number 3, IC741 or MUA741 IC na main use martivi lab naga, it will come with inbuilt offset compensation network. So basically pin number 1 and pin number 5 are connected with a potentiometer of 10k, and pin number 4, which is connected to negative supply, will be taken as that pin which will be varied between these two values to adjust the resistance so that the output voltage is nullified when you don't apply any input voltage. So this is what you do, small adjustment when you start operating your op amp for actual applications. Idu inbuilt offset compensation network. So basically we need not to worry about the op amp's compensating network when we use IC741, which is the most frequently and most widely used op amp device in the labs and all the commercial setups. So basically pin number 1 and pin number 5 naduva there will be a 10k pot, and I can vary that with the help of my connecting this particular knob to these two things. So I can connect a 10k pot between pin number 1 and 5 and then adjust my pot values to both the ends until I get output voltage to zero. Yavaga nanu output voltage zero varthati, then I can say that it is balanced. So this is what is basically happening in your inbuilt offset compensation. Now let's try to understand how exactly the offset compensating network can be designed for those op amps which doesn't have the inbuilt offset compensation pins. ಕೆಲವೊಂದ್ ಐ ಸಿ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಒಪ್ಯಾಂಪ್ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ದೀಸ್ ಪಿನ್ಸ್ ಟು ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಸಮ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಮೀಟರ್ ಓವರ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಂತದ್ರೊಳಗೆ ಐ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ಲೂಸಿವ್ಲಿ ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಅನ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ಕಂಪೆನ್ಸೇಷನ್ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಅನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಮೀಟರ್ ಆರ್ ಎ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಪ್ಲಸ್ ವಿ ಸಿ ಸಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ವಿ ಇ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸಿ ಈಸ್ ದ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್ ವಿ ಟು So by adjusting the wiper on RA, the wiper adjust madkondo, voltage V2, that is here, that is voltage across RC. So this V2 can be made equal to V1. You know, V1 and money already zero, so it is grounded. So V2 nuna ground madde, but output nuna zero barlela. Ava again madthini, I should go for compensation network. But unfortunately, I see that this particular IC is not IC741. ಸೊ ಇದ್ರೊಳಗಡೆ ಕಂಪೆನ್ಸೇಷನ್ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅವ್ರ ಕಂಪೆನ್ಸೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ಬಿಲ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ಕಂಪೆನ್ಸೇಷನ್ ಸಿನಾರಿಯೋ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಶುಡ್ ಡೂ ಐ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲ್ ಕಂಪೆನ್ಸೇಟಿಂಗ್ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ವಿಚ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಶೋನ್ ಓವರ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸಿನಾರಿಯೋ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ವಿ ಟು ಟು ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯೋ ಮೀಟರ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ವಿ ಸಿ ಸಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ವಿ ಇ ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ಅಡ್ಜಸ್ಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ನಾಬ್ ಐ ಮೂವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಸಿ ಸಿ ಆರ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ವಿ ಇ ಅಂಟಿಲ್ ಐ ಗೆಟ್ ಸಮ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಓವರ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಮೈ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಟು ಝೀರೋ So that is what I am going to ensure in offset compensating network that I am building externally. So this is what is basically happens in case of external offset compensating network. So just remember one thing, whenever your op-amp, if they are showing this kind of network, that is only to ensure the compensation of the, that is only to ensure to avoid the offset voltage or to nullify the offset voltages or to ensure output voltage is made zero before you apply the actual inputs. ಯಾವಾಗ ಈ ಟೈಪ್ ತೋರಿಸಿರಂಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅಥವಾ ಈ ಟೈಪ್ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಗರೇಷನ್ ಇರಂಗಿಲ್ಲ ದೆನ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡ್ ಸಚ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಗರೇಷನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಶೋನ್ ಓವರ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲಿ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ದಿ ಅದರ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ಕಂಪೆನ್ಸೇಷನ್ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ಕಂಪೆನ್ಸೇಷನ್ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ here in this particular aspect. Now let's move ahead. So this was one thing that I just wanted to highlight you, because I whenever I want to show you with respect to some amplifier configuration, these things will come into picture. So now let's just get into one more aspect. I just going to draw the things. I hope this is made clear. So now there is something called as input bias current. So there is something called as input bias current. So even this will make some kind of variations at the output side, but the variations caused by input bias currents is comparatively lower than the variations caused by the input that is offset input offset voltage. So input bias current andre enappa, so input bias current is basically defined as the average of two input bias currents IB1 and IB2. So what exactly is your IB1 and IB2? So let me just draw you. And mind you, all these things are not for your actual syllabus. These are only to make you understand what these things look or how these things work. So I just wanted to convey you how exactly these parameters mean, or what exactly these parameters mean. So that's the reason I'm taking up. So let me just quickly go through this, because the outcome of this you can see in the next subsequent circuits. Now on the circuit draw madadaga there I'll be keep on mentioning some parameters alli nimge gottagutte why I did all these things. So basically I assume that VIO is zero andre no ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಸದ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು ಇಲ್ಲ, ಅಥವಾ ಈ ಒಂದು ಐ ಸಿ ಹೆಂಗದಪ್ಪ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ನನಗೇನು ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ನಾಗ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೇರಿಯೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ದ ಮೊಮೆಂಟ್ ಐ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ದಿ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜಸ್ ದ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್ಸ್ ಟು ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ದಿ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಝೀರೋ. ಹೌದಾ? ಸೊ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಕೇಸ್ನ ಹೆಂಗಾಗಿತ್ತು, ನನಗೆ ಝೀರೋ ಬರ್ತಿದ್ದಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಎಷ್ಟು ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಬಂದಿರ್ತಿತ್ತು ಅದರ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ ಅಪೋಸಿಟ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂನ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೆ. ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಐದರ್ ಕಂಪೆನ್ಸೇಟಿಂಗ್ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನಲಿ ಆರ್ ಕಂಪೆನ್ಸೇಟಿಂಗ್ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲಿ ವಿಚ್ ಐ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್. But ಈಗ ಸದ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಅಸ್ಯೂಮ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ, ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ನೋ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ದ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಟ್ ಝೀರೋ. ಬಟ್ ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಅಸ್ಯೂಮ್ ದಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಸಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ವೇರಿಯೇಷನ್, ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ವೇರಿಯೇಷನ್, ನಾಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಬಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ನಾವು ಅಗೇನ್ ಲುಕ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್? ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಆರ್ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಬಯಾಸ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಿಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಐ ಬಿ ಒನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ಬಿ ಟೂ? ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ದಿ ಬೇಸ್ ಬಯಾಸ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟೂ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಓವರ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾವಲ್ಲ, ಆ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಬೇಸ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್. ಲೈಕ್ ಐ ವಾಸ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್, ನೋ two transistors are same and hence IB will be different. If IB is are different, then IB1 and IB2 resulting from the two transistors at present inside the op amp will be different. If the two currents are different, then the resulting voltages will be having some variations over here, and because of these two difference in the currents, the output will not be zero, but it will be having some varied value. Of course, the variation hangirthadla input offset voltage kinta kammi irthati, but still there will be small variation, but kammi irta antand I cannot ignore it. So usually it will be in terms of nano amperes. So now I should ensure, how do I nullify again output voltage to zero? And hang madbeku nanu, now output voltage is getting some variations because of bias currents, so now I should ensure again output voltage is made zero. So if you want to do that, then I need to be eliminating these currents by devising some scheme at the input side. Adan madbeku antandre, let's try to build, or let's try to obtain some quick small derivation. Let's try to do it. So what I'll do, if I want to calculate, so I'm assuming this is V1, this is V2. So V2 can be given as R1 parallel RF multiplied by IB2, and this I2 is coming over here from the output side, yeah, and I1 is coming over here. This is IB2, this is IB1. So R1 parallel RF multiplied by IB2 will be my V2, or V2 can be written as R1 RF divided by R1 plus RF multiplied by IB2. So this is what is my output, V2 voltage at this particular node. So if I want to apply node equation at V2, so node equation hang barithi nanu, I1 plus I2 equal to IB2. So this is what is the node currents over here. Now let us express I1 and I2 in terms of voltages. So this is what, 0, I1 is coming from ground, 0 minus V2 divided by R1 plus I2 is what, V0, or instead of writing V0, let me write it as V0 IB. So bare V0 anukintanu, V0 is because of input bias current, so V0 IB minus V2 divided by RF is equal to what is IB2. Can I write IB2 as V2 divided by RI? Because IB2 is coming over here, it is because of V2 whole divided by the input resistance RI. So if this is the case, then if I do the simplification, so VOIB by RF is equal to V2 1 by R1 plus 1 by RF plus 1 by RI. So this is what I'm going to get. So I'm just separating VOIB by RF one side and other terms as at the other side. And since RI is very, very high, I can ignore that. So that will make you 1 by R1 plus 1 by RF. That will fetch me value of V2 multiplied by R1 plus RF divided by R1 RF. So VOIB by RF is equal to this value I'm going to get. So if I substitute in this equation, let me call it that equation number two. What was the value of V2 that we obtained earlier? So V2 we obtained, let me write the beginning. V2 was R1 RF divided by R1 plus RF multiplied by V2. So that was my equation number one. So if I substitute equation number one in equation number two, and I just remove this, even I have this. So if I substitute equation number one in equation number two, what is that I'm going to get? VOIB multiplied or divided by RF is equal to. So in place naga, I'm going to substitute this entire term. R1 RF divided by R1 plus RF into IB2 multiplied by R1 plus RF divided by R1 RF. So all these cancel out. So I'll bring this over here. So VIOB is equal to IB2 into RF. So basically output offset voltage due to input bias current is having a very high dependency on my this RF. So in order to ensure, so in my the earlier circuit was, if I want to eliminate or if I want to ensure the to reduce the output offset voltage due to bias current, then we need to devise some scheme at the input by which the output, by which the voltage V1 can be made equal to V2. So if, in other words, if voltages V1 and V2 caused by currents IB1 and IB2 are equal, then output voltage caused by these IB will be definitely zero. Hang panthara nanage output offset voltage nanage result ishtu bantu. So if IB1 and IB2 are causing V1 and V2, because of which there is some VOIB, if I devise a mechanism wherein if I make sure IB1 and IB2 are made equal, then these two will be equal. And if these two are equal, then offset output voltage will be reduced to zero. So if aagbek paantandra, then I'll be ensuring IB2 into RF equal to IB1 into some resistance I'm going to call it as ROM. So basically I'm making I into R, that is voltages. So it's not IB2 is because of V2, IB1 is because of V1, and IB2 is having a relation with RF, IB1 is having relation with some resistance ROM. Adu yav resistance nanu gottilla, I need to be finding it out. So if I somehow make the currents equal, that makes me voltages equal. If both the input voltages are equal, then output voltage will be nullified to zero. Then it will be balanced. And aagbek antandre I'll be equating both the voltages in terms of current and resistance. So IB2 RF illan bandittu. Similarly, IB1 multiplied by some resistance. Our resistance I'm calling it as ROM. So what will be my ROM here? Whatever is the value of RF, that will be your ROM, or ROM whatever will be the value that is produced by RF, that will be the value of ROM. So if I ensure that this is being matched, then I say that my outcome will be nullified, and ROM value, if I calculate R1 RF divided by R1 plus RF, so this is what I am going to get for this ROM. So in my input circuit, if I ensure that some external resistance is being applied, that will ensure that input bias current is nullified. If input bias current is nullified, then output voltage because of input bias currents will be nullified. So this is what is the basic concept that we will understand in terms of bias currents producing some sort of offset voltages. So I hope this has been made clear. Now the reason for telling these things is mainly because I'll just share you a PPT now. Okay, can you see this PPT? Please respond me.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, yesterday I think someone asked me about these bias currents and bias voltages. Look here. So this is what is being applied over here. That's what I was telling yesterday. So this op amp comes with internal biasing mechanism wherein between pin number 1 and 5, there is a 10K pot is being applied and it is being moved accordingly to ensure the offset voltage is nullified before you apply any input voltage. And what is this ROM? ಇದು ಆರ್ ಓ ಎಂ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ನೋ ವಿಫಿ ಗೌಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ಟು ಎನ್ಶೋರ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಈಸ್ ನಲಿಫೈಡ್ ಟು ಝೀರೋ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಬಯಾಸ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಆರ್ ಓ ಎಂ ನಾ ಏನ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ಮಿನಿಮೈಸಿಂಗ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಎನ್ಶೋರ್ ಹೌ ಡು ವಿ ನಲಿಫೈ ದಿ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಟು ಝೀರೋ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಬಯಾಸ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅದ್ರ ಸಂಬಂಧ ಆರ್ ಓ ಎಂ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಇದು ಯಾಕೆ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಪ್ಪ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹೌ ಶುಡ್ ಐ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದಿ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಟು ಝೀರೋ ಕಾಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಸಮ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ವಿಚ್ ಐ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಇದು ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಕಂಪೆನ್ಸೇಟಿಂಗ್ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಇದು ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಬಯಾಸ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಕಂಪೆನ್ಸೇಟಿಂಗ್ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವೈ ದ ರೀಸನ್ ವಿ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಶೋ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ವಿ ರೈಟ್ ದಿ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಗರೇಷನ್ ನೌ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಒಪ್ ಆಂಪ್ ಸರ್ಕಿಟ್ರಿ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ಡ್ರಾ Now this is with respect to inverting op-amp with offset null circuitry. And the same is case with respect to non-inverting. It has got inbuilt mechanism and this is to ensure the how do I minimize the bias current effect. And with respect to differential amplifier, the same thing over here. There is a what is known as inbuilt mechanism to nullify the input offset voltage. And there is since it is a differential amplifier, I will be applying the voltages Vx and Vy over here between two terminals. As of now, I don't require the nullifying mechanism to nullify the bias current effect. So only input offset voltage compensating network is fine. Now let's just go into how exactly your external offset voltage looks. This is what I just show you. So look here. ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ನನಗೆ ಪಿನ್ ನಂಬರ್ 1 ಮತ್ತು 5 ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಟೈಮ್ ನಾನು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ನಾನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್ ಐ ಟೇಕ್ ಔಟ್ ಒನ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಬಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ದಿ ಪಾಟ್ ಐ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಮೂವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಐದರ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ವಿಸಿಸಿ ಆರ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ವಿಇ ಟು ಎನ್ಶೋರ್ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಮ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಓವರ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟು ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ರೀಡ್ ಟು ಝೀರೋ ಸೊ ಇದನ್ನ ಯಾವಾಗ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಐ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಆಕ್ಚುಲ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಕೊಡೋಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಮುಂಚೆ ಐ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಡೂ ದೀಸ್ ಮೆಕಾನಿಸಮ್ ಕಂಪೆನ್ಸೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಓವರ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿತ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ನಾನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ So not look at the difference in the inverting configuration. The compensating network is present at the non-inverting side. In the non-inverting network, the compensation network is present at the inverting side. ಯಾಕ ಪಾತನ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ನಾನು ನಾನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ನಾಗ ನಾನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ನಾಗ ಕೊಟ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿರ್ತೀನಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ನ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಾಗ ಕಂಪೆನ್ಸೇಷನ್ ನಾನು ಅದರ ಅಪೋಸಿಟ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ನ ನಾನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ನಾಗ ಕೊಟ್ಟಾಗ ಕಂಪೆನ್ಸೇಷನ್ ಅನ್ನು ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ಇಸ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದಿ inverting and non-inverting configurations in terms of external offset voltage compensating network. And the same is the case with respect to differential. So now here input got in here, I can go ahead with either here or here. Now there is not a big issue because both the terminals are acting as input. So here drive one could use more. So this is with respect to differential amplifier with offset null circuitry with external offset voltage compensating network. So this is what I just wanted to convey you with respect to the offset voltages. And finally, how your the op-amp can act as an AC inverting amplifier. So if I want to amplify the AC signals, then I should be avoiding the amplification of DCs. So I'll be applying or I'll be connecting a coupling capacitor over here, which will block the DCs and it will only allow AC signal and thereby making this as a pure AC inverting amplifier. Baki yalla components will remain intact. That is the compensating network, the input bias compensating network, the input voltage compensating network, R1, RF, all will remain same. The only difference here, it will have a additional capacitor. And in case of non-inverting amplifier, the capacitor will be present at the non-inverting side. So this is how your op-amp can behave as both inverting configuration as well as non-inverting configuration. So this is what I just wanted to show you. Now let's just get into, and I'm going to share the screen again. Yeah, so I just want to make you aware how the numericals are being asked in the examinations and how to solve them. So I am taking the numericals straight away from the textbook. So I'll be mentioning the page number. Please ensure you just go through that page number. So just read the problem statements. Yeah, so page number 245, example 6.6. So this is what is one question he is asking. The question says, he is giving a circuit. He mentions in a circuit mentioned in figure 6.6. So the 6.6 circuit was something like this. So this is my circuit he has given. R1, R. So as he has mentioning RA, RB, RC, VA, VB, VC. So there is a feedback resistance as well. RF. So the problem statement says, in this circuit, if VA is 100 millivolt, so this is 100 millivolt, VB is minus 200 millivolt, and VC is 300 millivolt, RA is 3K, RB is 2.2K, and RC is 1K, RF is 4.7K, ROM is 470 ohm, and RL is 10K. If this is a scenario, determine the output voltage. Now, can anybody tell me quickly what kind of configuration it is, whether it is a inverting configuration or non-inverting? It is an inverting configuration because all the voltages you are applying to the inverting configuration. So definitely output will be minus some value. And what kind of application it is? It is basically behaving as a summing amplifier. So if this is summing amplifier, how was your equation for the summing amplifier look? The summing amplifier equation was minus times RF by RA multiplied by VA plus RF by RB multiplied by VB plus RF by RB RC multiplied by VC. So this was my equation. Now you know RF, RF value has been given, you know RA, RA value has been given, and VA, VB, VC values have also been mentioned. Whatever is the value they have mentioned, you just take that. Minus 200 means minus 200 is worry. And I hope all the terms, units will cancel out and you are going to get the final voltage as a some negative volt. So I'm going to leave this as an assignment to you. I'm going to mention this as a part of an assignment question. And I have showed you how to solve this question. Please try to remember this and try to get the result. So this is one kind of problem that could be asked in the examination. Now, the next problem is again, problem number 6.7. He says, repeat the same problem for RA, RB, RC equal to 1 kilo ohm. If RA, RB, RC is equal to 1 kilo ohm, so this is the scenario. RA, RB, RC, all are 1K. I know this is 1K. So all are 1K, then how does your output voltage looks? So RF anto na change madila, RF is 4.7. So let me solve this quickly. So if I take out RF outside and VA by RA, VB by RB, VC by RC, so VA is 100 milli by 1K, RA is 1K. And then what is VB? Minus 200 milli by 1K. And then VC is what, 300 milli by 1K. So RF is anyhow 4.7K. So K and milli, kilo and milli, kilo and milli, they cancel out. So 100 plus 300, 400 minus 200 is 200, 200 multiplied by 4.7. So that will be your final output voltage. So this is what will be your output voltage equation for this particular problem number 6.7. So this is again a one kind of problem that he mentions over here. And then in the equation, in the question 6.8, let's try to do that quickly. He has given the figure. The figure what he has given is this one. So this is the figure he has given. So what sort of configuration it is? So it is a non-inverting configuration, because input you are giving to the non-inverting terminal. So VA, VB, VC has given. So let's see what exactly he has given. He has given VA equal to VB equal to 1.5. So this is 1.5, this is 1.5. VC is 3 volt. And R1 equal to R equal to 1.5. So basically your all these values are equal to 1.5 kilo ohm. So all the values are 1.5k, here also 1.5k. And he has, he has not given this R and R1 he has given. So RF he has not given. And he has given the output voltage as 5.2 volt. Now the question is, what is the value of RF that is required to ensure output voltage is 5.2? Now you need to be identifying the circuit first. The circuit is simply a non-inverting summing amplifier, and you have all the voltages, you have all the resistance values. You are just supposed to apply the equation. So what is basically the formula for non-inverting summing amplifier, which we have done yesterday? So the non-inverting summing amplifier equation was 1 plus RF by R1 multiplied by VA plus VB plus VC whole divided by 3. So this is what is the equation that we obtained yesterday. So if this is the scenario, I know R1 he has given all values as 1.5. RF I don't know, let me keep it as it is. VABC values he has given, and V0 value he has given as 5.2. You use that, substitute that, and extract what is the value of RF. So you are going to get the output as the value of RF will be, it will be in terms of, it will be larger than these values. Preferably it will be in terms of mega ohms. It has to be large, because the feedback resistance will be always greater than the other resistances in the circuit. So this is about your equation, the problem number 6.8. And moving ahead. Yeah. Now, in the exercises, that is in the page number 247, there is something called as design problems. So ELI R problems, though these problems are even just numericals. Now there are some design problems. Now, from your examination point of view, from your BTU examination point of view, these questions could be possibly asked in the examination. Like one such problem is what mentioned as 6.25. What he mentions, design a summing amplifier to add 3 DC voltages. The output of this circuit must be equal to 2 times the negative sum of the inputs. So if this is the problem, then you should arrive at the derivation. And in order to arrive at the derivation, you should know what is the end result. End in an yen beku. What should I get? So here he has mentioned in terms of statement. What he has mentioned? One edu. This is a summing amplifier. Summing amplifier anta one mention manana. And output of the circuit must be equal to 2 times negative sum of the inputs. So 2 times negative sum of the input under minus of these values. And basically what are the inputs he is asking? How many inputs he has said? There are 3 DC voltages. So VA, VB, VC are my 3 voltages, and my output should be twice the negative of these things. So what configuration it results? So basically, it is resulting into an inverting summing amplifier. So look, this is how the questions could be formed. Now you may come, tough question, Mantri sir. The question was very twisted. So this is how the questions could be asked. Rather than giving a problem with this particular statement, he will give a problem in terms of a return statement, and you should devise the outcome like this. And from here onwards, you should start the solving the problems. Now, basically, and VA, VB, VC, Gantu, with minus 2 in the inverting amplifier, you just compare this equation with the standard equation of the inverting amplifier. So this is my standard equation. V naught is equal to minus RF by R1, VA plus VB plus VC. Right, and VA ABC, then yesterday gotilla, I'll keep it as VABC. But what is the value of RF by R1? RF by R1 value has given as 2. So if RF by R1 is 2, so what will be RF and R1? That you can do it by assuming let RF equal to 10 mega ohm. So then definitely R1 will be 5 mega ohm. Because as per the equation, it should give me a result of 2. So this is how you should start designing the problem. So these are all your design problems. Then usually in our question paper, we talk about level 3, level 4, right? So these are those kind of problems. So we'll stop it over here. We can continue in the next class with some more design problems and the summary of these applications before heading to the last part of this chapter, that is comparators, zero crossing detectors, Schmitt trigger, and instrumentation amplifier. So these four concepts are remaining in this particular module, and till we cover up those things, we'll summarize this and we'll solve few more numericals, and then we can wind up the session. So that's it from today's class. So attendance link has been already floated. The code for the attendance link is mentioned on the screen. You can just look on the screen. The attendance code is mentioned on your screen. You can just type that and give the attendance. Guys, I hope the things are getting cleared. And if you find any difficulty in understanding the concepts, please let me know whenever you find difficulty. We can have again the revision classes, and we can always see to that the concepts are made clear. See, the intention is simple. This chapter being very easy, although it looks like the concepts are very vast, but once in an e module mugudmale, if we summarize, we can see that there are hardly 6 to 7 concepts. The way how we did it in the first semester basic electronics, in a similar manner we'll perform. There are hardly 6 to 7 concepts, and if you are thorough in these 6 to 7 concepts along with some 2 to 3 categories of numericals, then definitely this module is going to fetch you a good marks for your examination. So please ensure that you are thorough in all the concepts whatever are being taught here. And in case of issues, in case of difficulties, in case of any problems or complexity in understanding things, please text me, please let me know. We'll sort the things then and there only. So this is all about the concept that we have known till now. So we'll stop it over here. We can continue it in the next class.
There's no links.
No link is shared, sir.
Link is same link.
Yesterday, sir.
Adhe link irutte. That won't change. Now I have shared it. I hope you got the link.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
The code you just note down from the screen and then put the attendance.